Yeah, so yesterday we had a little green sea turtle come in from 90 Mile Beach south in Northland. It was found stranded on the beach by a member of the public, and Department of Conservation went and flew it down to us when it was clear it was sick. This little green turtle is the first one that we've had for the season. It came in after some big storms, which is about when we would expect to see a sick turtle wash up in New Zealand. And this one's got the worst conditioned shell that we've seen. So it's covered in a really thick moss, which is not something we usually see down this part of the world. It's got a lot of goose barnacles as well on it, which is something that we often do see in a sick turtle.
Under all this moss and all these barnacles, you can see the brown, which is the normal layer on the top of the shell, and this black line that's abnormal shell, and this yellow is where some quite deep tissues come away. Makes us worry that that's let infection and stuff inside, so we have to have a really good look. We'll get some x-rays today, see what we can see.
When he first came in, like a few hours ago, it was 14, so it'd be good just to see if he's increased in temp while in a warmer room and warmer environment. The warmer we can get them, the better they can process their meds. So we really want to get them up to about 20, 24 degrees.
So we did x-rays, we took some bloods, and we started supportive care. So we put them into a intensive care unit, essentially, where we have warm water dripping over just to start to slowly warm the body back up to a better temperature. So the endangered green sea turtle that we had in recently, unfortunately the day after it arrived, we found it dead when we went to do treatments in the afternoon. And we've now since then done a full post-mortem on it, and the condition of those bony plates on the top of the shell was the worst that we've seen through here. A significant amount of that damage was actually caused by sun. So when a turtle gets sick, they often float on the top of the water, and that exposes them to sunburn. That's part of what we're seeing with the shell of this turtle. The second thing that we noticed as soon as we opened up the turtle and had a look at the inside of it was that there were no fat stores at all. So usually when you open up a turtle, you can see quite a nice layer of fat, particularly if it's a healthy turtle, if it's one that's been doing well. You can see a really nice thick layer of fat, and that's the body supply, so that's what they use for their energy and to keep themselves going. And unfortunately with this little one, it just had no fat at all. But what we did find in the intestines was two bits of plastic as well as a big long piece of twine. So the twine in this case was all knotted up together, and which can cause obstructions and can cause problems passing through. Another reminder to ourselves that when we're out there in the environment, making sure that anything we take out there comes back. Go and enjoy the beach, go and enjoy being out on your boat and fishing, but bring everything you take out back. Make sure you don't leave anything behind.